Kamino, one of the most interesting but ignored planets in all of Star Wars. Birthplace to all Jango Fett clones. Home to a species called the Kaminoans. A planet of mystery and a ton of history that this video will go over. So without further ado, let's get right into today's video. Starting off with number one, in my opinion, one of the weirdest and coolest facts about Kamino. Hundreds of years before the Clone Wars, the planet was not an ocean planet, but actually it was a green, beautiful planet, much like our own. Normal oceans, normal trees, forests, jungles, and normal weather, until a huge ice age. Although it is actually unknown exactly how many Kaminoans died, it is estimated that a large portion of the population was killed by the Ice Age. As the remaining Kaminoans rebuilt and recovered from the Ice Age, the planet started to return to its normal temperature. And of course, the Kaminoans were not prepared, and as the ice started to melt, the planet started to flood. When the mountaintops just weren't enough, they started to build huge tower building things. I really don't know what you would call them, but I'm sure you know what I'm talking about. They built those huge above sea level buildings, and that's how they got to where they are now. Moving on to number two, how the Kaminoans got started cloning. Thousands of years of advancing in science, chemistry, and much more, Kaminoans are still just mainly known for their unique and amazing skill of cloning. Also, by the way, I'm really sorry, it's like there's a giant thunderstorm outside my window, so I really do apologize if you hear that. But like I was saying, just like any other civilization, they didn't start off intelligent. It was just before their planet's massive ice age that they actually started to expand on their minds. And then there was the Ice Age. Pretty much all the advancements that they made had pretty much got left behind and forgotten about, until they started to adapt to the extreme temperatures and ice. Then came the very unfortunate melting of the ice, or the flood. The Kaminoans were obviously torn down once again, but this time they essentially threw out all the weak people in their colonies, and that's when the Kaminoans became obsessed with making the most genetically perfect beings and started cloning. One of the quote-unquote unique traits that the Kaminoans picked up was essentially having no emotions, which I'll talk on a little bit later. But as I was saying, they had no emotions, which unfortunately caused the Kaminoans to be extremely brutal with the clones. When Kaminoans first started cloning, they literally cloned whatever was asked by people to clone. For the right price, of course. Whether it was for slaves or just random soldiers, they just cloned them. Until they were approached by some certain people that instructed the Kaminoans to create the clone troopers that we all know and love. By the way, I'm super excited to see what happens to Kamino in the Bad Batch. Number 3, Kamino's very dark past. I saved this one till the end because it's really dark and really interesting. I think it's pretty safe to say that Kaminoans have always been a bit selfish. Just by simply looking at their history, we see them literally killing their own people, either because they were overpopulated or there just wasn't enough supplies to go around. They never hesitated to kill some of their own just for their own survival, which actually led their species to have no emotions. We actually don't know a lot about exactly how they lost their emotions, but because they lost their emotions, they did some very messed up things. They ruthlessly murdered their own people for the smallest things, such as someone having a weird face, arm, leg, you name it. They got to the point where they would kill off so many of their own that they got obsessed with making their own perfect Kaminoan. They were completely sold on the idea of having the perfect specimen. As their obsession grew, they got down to eye color. They essentially had a rank system of their own eye color. Lower class Kaminoans had blue eyes, middle class Kaminoans had yellow eyes, and upper class Kaminoans had gray eyes. Eventually, they got to the point where the only differences between themselves were their eye colors, which they had to identify their class. Honestly, if you ask me, the perfect being was already alive. Jar Jar Binks. I honestly can't believe that they wasted their time on that when they could have just cloned Jar Jar. Could you imagine an army of just Jar Jars just like running on a battlefield? Overall, though, they did grow to the point to where they got exactly what they wanted, which was for their species to be genetically perfect. And that was today's video. I really hope you all enjoyed it. If you did enjoy it, it would be very nice if you could drop a like, and if you like this kind of content, maybe consider subscribing. And also, I just wanted to say, if you're struggling at all on YouTube, or just want to grow your channel, I highly recommend using an awesome YouTube tool called VidIQ. If you're interested in VidIQ, then go down to the special link in the description, or go to vidiq.com/snow. And with all that being said, I really hope you all have a wonderful day, and as always, may the force be with you all.